I'm gonna try to destroy this piece right in front of your eyes with our epoxy durability test. Learn how to keep your projects looking like the day you poured. We're talking epoxy top coats. Replacing your kitchen or bathroom countertops is a big deal. You could save thousands off other countertop options by coating over your existing or building new with Stone Coat Epoxy. I'm gonna show you right now which epoxy top coat is best for you and how to apply it. Stay tuned, folks, and enjoy the video. You got this! The ultimate top coat has been curing for about 1 week. I'm gonna slide this weight across it. I'm gonna impact test. I'm gonna drop some screws. I'm gonna throw everything I have at the ultimate top coat. I'm gonna start out with a notch trowel scratch test. I got a cup and it's midway full of change. It's heavier than any cup full of liquid. Order up. All right. That cup didn't leave a single scratch. Hi, honey, I'm home from work. Just let me empty out my pockets.
Zero scratches from all those screws.
We're gonna do the slide test with a 35-pound dumbbell with sharp corners.
On top of my epoxy countertop with zero damage.
Dang, that is some tough stuff. Hammer impact test. Hammer impact test, success. Mitch, the hammer's not tough enough. 4-pound hammer test. The flame test. Ooh, it's getting warm. All right, that's nice and hot. Onto the counter. Ooh. Perfection! The Blaze King! We've thrown everything but the kitchen sink at this top coat, and it hasn't been phased yet. Now for the ultimate cut test. Here we go. Don't ever take a knife to your top coat or epoxy surface. It will cut it. Always use a cutting board. I got a chunk of natural granite right here. It costs anywhere from $65 to $120 a square foot. I've got stone coat over 3/4 inch piece of MDF with the top coat. That's $6 a square foot.
The 4-pound drop test.
Okay, that didn't survive. Now our pretty expensive countertop is in 2 pieces. Now, the 4-pound hammer test on a stone coat countertop for the ultimate top coat. Looking good. You guys aren't convinced? How about this? I blew up my tripods underneath and we are still good to go. Don't get me wrong, granite countertops are top of the line, best of the best, but they're very expensive. We offer you a customizable, very beautiful countertop option that you can afford and apply right over your existing surfaces. I went a little crazy with my durability test, but I wanted to showcase just how tough this stuff really is.
That was intense, and there's no damage left behind. Up first, I'm gonna show you how to apply a final clear flood coat using Stone Coat Epoxy. The clear flood coat is easy. Sand, measure, mix, trowel, chop, torch, allow it to cure. The clear flood coat will be dry to the touch in 24 hours and ready for light kitchen use in 72. Now let's get started.
Lightly hand sand with 220 grit on the surface and edges of the countertop. Measure up 3 ounces per square foot of countertop at a 1-to-1 ratio, pouring in part B first, followed by part A. Mix the epoxy for 2 minutes using a paddle mixer and a drill. You can also use a paint stick, just extend your mixing time. Take time to scrape the bottom and sides to incorporate any undermixed epoxy clinging to the sides and bottom of your bucket.
Epoxy's mixed.
Pour the epoxy in a ribbon in the center of your project. Use our 1/8 inch by 1/8 inch square notch trowel to evenly spread the clear Stone Coat epoxy. Mix the material amongst itself before starting to spread the epoxy over the surface. Keep the epoxy away from the edges at first to keep the material from running off prematurely. Use the leading edge of the notch trowel to push a small amount of epoxy over the edges. Remove any loose bristles out of the paintbrush by pulling on the end and running through your fingers. Doing this before the brush is wet with epoxy will keep any loose bristles from curing in the epoxy. Pre-prime and wet your brush in the mixed epoxy before chopping the top. In a random pattern, use the heel of the brush and chop the surface of the countertop. This will remove any subtle trowel lines left in the epoxy and will mix the material one final time. Cover the entire surface and no need to be in a rush. You have tons of time to work with the epoxy and have it lay out like a crystal clear sheet of glass. With light pressure, use that brush to coat your edges. Next up, we're going to easily remove the air from the epoxy with some heat. You can use a heat gun, a propane torch, or even a blow dryer. Keep the heat gun or torch head moving in a sweeping motion, taking time to torch the entire surface. You're gonna wanna torch or use the heat gun at least 3 times, taking time to let the epoxy cool a minute or two between torchings.
Applying a clear coat of Stone Coat countertop epoxy is easy. It adds a layer of protection over those color techniques down below. This clear coat will lay out like a sheet of glass and cure nice and glossy. The other option for your epoxy project's top coat is our ultimate top coat. I'm gonna let this cure, come back tomorrow, lightly sand and apply the ultimate top coat. I'm back, it's the next day. My clear coat is as smooth as glass, cured perfectly. It's time to apply the ultimate top coat. If your customer wants that matte finish or the more natural look and feel of the ultimate top coat, you can bypass applying that clear coat of Stone Coat countertop epoxy and go right to the ultimate top coat. Time to sand.
Like applying a clear flood coat, lightly sand with 220 grit to rough up the smooth epoxy so the ultimate top coat will have a great bond.
Finish off by lightly hitting the edges with that 220 grit.
Remove the sanding dust with a roll of paper towels.
Before using brand new microfiber rollers, you're gonna wanna de-lint them with some masking tape. I do that by just hooking it to my piece, and then while on the roller cage, give it a quick roll. The surface is prepped and ready to go. It's time to mix up the ultimate top coat. Be sure to mix up part A thoroughly. There's a matting agent that likes to settle, so give it a quick shake, and then you're ready to measure.
Stone Coat's ultimate top coat is a 2-to-1 hybrid coating technology formulated to stand up to everyday kitchen and bathroom use and abuse. Measure part A first, then part B. Mix the top coat thoroughly with a paint stick for 2 to 3 minutes.
After thoroughly mixing, I'm gonna add about 1/2 ounce of water. Not very much, just a little bit. Give it another mix. Okay, this material is ready to use. Pour the material in there to that paint tray. I'm gonna use the short-handled roller frame to apply the top coat wet. Saturate the roller and then get any excess off and apply it to the center of the project.
We apply the top coat with the 2-roller method, one wet roller and one dry. That gives you that professional sprayed on like finish. Use the top coat in the center of the project as your reservoir and feather the material out over the surface of the countertop.
All right, hit those edges with the wet roller. I don't have to be in a rush, but I also don't have the same working time as I do with the stone coat countertop epoxy. If this were a large kitchen, I would start with the island, mix up more, and do the perimeter. I'd probably do a 50 square foot kitchen in two batches until I was comfortable enough with the working time to do the entire kitchen with one batch. All right, I'm gonna give it one quick dry roll with the pressure on the frame of the roller. I'm barely pushing down, just gliding across that surface.
Light pressure is all that is needed, and keep from over dry rolling. One to two light passes does the trick.
And this project is ready to dry. Installing the ultimate top coat was super simple. It will be dry to the touch in 6 to 8 hours and ready for light kitchen use the next day. If the ultimate top coat could handle what I just threw at it, it definitely can handle what your kids or your spouse can throw at your completed countertops. Stone Coat's ultimate top coat was formulated and designed to be tough and withstand everyday kitchen use and abuse. If you have an old epoxy project a few years to a few months old, it's okay, it's not too late to add the ultimate top coat. Jump on over to Stone Coat Countertops to see the two versions of the ultimate top coat we now carry. The natural matte finish that you see here, and now carrying the high gloss version. Thanks for watching, folks. Remember, from Stone Coat Countertops, you got this, and we'll see you on the next video.